I like it when someone walks into my office and says, I've got a movie that's just like Tootsie. And then I want to say, but, and then they'll say, well, mine's like Tootsie, but it goes in this direction or that direction, or here's why he has to put on a dress. And then I know they're not ripping it off. They found a new way to do a classic idea,
right,
which is dressing in drag. And that's just never, that's never going to go away. That's always going to be funny, but you want to hear a new version.
Give me the same thing, but different.
It's funny, but that's what they say.
Yeah.
Well, it's because the studios and the buyers feel more comfortable.
Of course.
If you can give them something that sounds like something they've done that did really well, but now they can promote it slightly differently. And that's hard to do.
Yeah.
But I'd rather look at a movie like The Graduate or Shampoo or any great classic comedies or classic thriller and then figure out new ways to do it. For instance, they did the story with Kevin Spacey this year, Bad, Horrible Bosses.
Mm-hmm.
They even acknowledged in the dialogue that they were doing Hitchcock's, now I'm going to blank on the title, it's the movie where the two guys switch and kill and try to kill each other's... What's the movie?
Strangers on a Train.
Terrible, I should be naming a movie, I can't think of. My point being, thank you for the, from the audience. Strangers on a Train is a classic premise. Two guys who are strangers meet on a train and figure out how they're going to kill people for each other. Well, Horrible Bosses, they're three guys meet and figure out they have horrible bosses and they decide they're going to kill each other's bosses.
Right.
That's Strangers on a Train, but it's not.
Because it's a buddy comedy.
It's a buddy comedy and it's about their bosses.
Right.
So they took the premise. I remember one of the first ones I heard that did that was a movie. It was about, called The Defiant Ones. That was the original. Tony Curtis and Sidney Poitier. A white man and an African American who break out of jail and they're handcuffed together.
Mm.
Then I heard a couple of years later, not a couple of years later, but when I was developing projects, some woman walked in and said, you know, I want to do The Defiant Ones, but I want to do it modern day with two women in prison.
Mm-hmm.
I thought, wait a minute, that's kind of smart, because all she's done is taken a classic movie and made it two women. She didn't even change the racial issue. She made one black and one white. So she kept the same premise, but she had a new way of telling it. Now, I don't recommend people go looking through old movies and just rip them off, but it does inspire you and say, that's a really good idea. What if you did it this way or that way? If you can't think of any original ideas, look at the best movies you've ever seen. Go to all the bookstores and online and read descriptions of your favorite movies from 10 years ago, 20 years ago. And you can be inspired to come up with new versions. Plus, most people, when they think of ideas, it's very hard to start getting outside your own brain, like other careers that people might have, other situations that might occur. You tend to go around like a loop with the same careers and the same characters from your own world. And you're not really thinking out of the box, but if you start making a list, for instance, of all the careers there are, someday you might write down bookstore or post office, whatever it is, and then you think, well, wait a minute, what about something there that is off-center from what you usually think about? Otherwise, you just keep doing the same stuff, because we all watch the same television shows and read the same books and see the same Oprah Winfreys and newspapers. You've got to find things that are, you know, get people excited because it sounds like something familiar, but like you said, there's something different happening.
Yeah.